Yo, what's up, guys? It's Josh here. And today we're going to be talking about this really weird, surrealist, experimental film I found a while ago. I've been meaning to make this video for a while now, but I just kept forgetting, or I would just put it off. Because there was other stuff I want to make, and there's still more stuff I want to make film-based, because I did a few anime videos, but I'm going to keep doing those, but not as often, because I really want to do more film-based stuff. But yeah, so today we're going to be talking about the Luis Buñuel, I'm assuming that's how you say it, directed a movie called The Exterminating Angel, or Angel Exterminador, that's the original title. He's Spanish, but the movie is it's based in Mexico and all that, just our Mexican, of course. So yeah, let's talk about The Exterminating Angel.
¿Dónde va usted?
Solo un ratito, voy a dar una vuelta.
Tenemos 20 personas para el supé. Solo usted podía ocurrirse ir a dar una vuelta ahora.
No había pensado en eso. Quizás tenga usted razón. Pero le aseguro que volveré lo antes posible.
Usted de aquí no.
But yeah, the movie, well, in short, the movie is about a couple that invites their old friends over for a dinner party. And they're all of the upper class. And once they do that, none of them can seem or able to leave the building. Or the room, to be more specific. They're all stuck in the room where the dinner party has taken place. Well, actually, no, they eat in the, of course, they eat in the kitchen area. Then after that, they move to the, I guess what you say, where they just lounge around and drink and eat, like, finger snacks or foods or whatever. So, yeah, they're unable to leave that room, I guess the living room. So they found themselves stuck in that room, all these members of the upper class dinner party. This movie is actually listed on a comedy. I could see how some scenes are funny, but I was like, how the fuck is this comedy? It's most definitely drama, fantasy, like, I guess. Fantasy comes from the fact that they're unable to leave. But I could see how it's meant to be comedy since it is a surrealist film. So, I mean, comedy, horror, and things like that, of that nature, they do go hand in hand, in my opinion. I mean, they're the same thing. Wait, two sides of the same coin? Yeah, that's the same. They're two sides of the same coin. So I could most definitely see how this movie is meant to be a comedy. But yeah, this movie is just about these upper class citizens in Mexico, some of which has traveled around the world, Mexico to America back, stuff like that. Some are writers, some are just doctors, stuff like that. They're all friends, and they all come together for this dinner party after they haven't been together for a minute. And it's kind of weird. It's kind of ominous. It's like they kind of came together for this reason. It's weird. See, that's why I like this movie. It has like this weird ominous thing about it. It's like they were meant to be there. Like they all kind of knew, but they didn't know. Like, it was more of a subconscious thing. But yeah, so, but in the same, it's the same for when they try to leave. They all try to leave, but it's like something always happens. They start to talk. They start to eat again, or something just comes up that prevents them from leaving. And it's a very interesting film about classism in the upper class, quote-unquote upper class society. It's pretty great, because by the middle of the movie, they're reduced to living how I guess they would see lower class citizens, or even middle class, because that's probably low to them as well. Living, and not all of them are assholes, because there's a few characters that are pretty decent human beings, but for the majority of them, you can see that their viewpoints of the world or of the people that they think are below them or below their class, their standards or whatever. So, like, they come to reduce the living like animals, pigs, or whatever, or the quote-unquote lower class, that's what they think, basically below the poverty line. They run out of food, they run out of water, they have nowhere to use the restroom, they can't shower because they're all stuck and confined into this room. And I think it's a really beautiful and excellent film. I'm going to try to stay away from turning this into a review because I don't like reviewing movies. I don't really like movie reviews. I like more discussions on films. And so that's why I really want this to be. But yeah, this movie is actually really beautiful, though. All Mexican cast. And I think the director himself is Spanish, though. I think he's from Spain, Luis Buñuel. I really hope I'm saying that. He's the writer and the director. But yeah. Yeah, this is just a really, really good surrealist movie that I think everyone should see. I really want to talk about more. I'm trying to formulate my words correctly because I'm reading what I've had down. But it's like, this movie's really weird. Like, so this is basically just a really lavish party that they're having. And they're all just mysteriously unable to leave. And like, for instance, oh, and all the help or maids or whatever you want to call them, they were, they all left except for one or two, if I remember correctly. Like, they were working happily, and out of nowhere, it was, like, a sudden change in their bodies that made them want to leave. Like, they were, like, coming up with lives or just anything to leave, or they would just leave. And I think the main butler stayed, and maybe one more. I cannot remember. I should have made this video when I first seen the movie, but stuff kept coming up. But, yeah, so they all left, and they kind of explaining the scene. They was, like, I guess they kind of knew that this was something like this was happening, but they didn't know exactly what. Because at first, they was blaming them. Because even me, let me try to explain. Avoid spoilers, but yeah, basically it's really weird, man. Like, this movie had me thinking, who did it, or like, why can't they leave? And the movie asks themselves, it's something they call the other characters witches, warlocks, stuff like this. They're blaming the help, the maids. They're saying, why are they none of them here? It's clearly them, or it's clearly you, the dude that's hosting the party, whose name I cannot remember. But damn, what is his name? Whatever. But yeah, Mundo, that sounds right, Mundo. They blame him. It's like, it's you. You're fucking doing this. It has to be you. This is your home. This is you and your wife's home. And at the point, and there's points where I really thought the wife herself did it, but it's a really weird movie because it's a lot of setups in this movie that make you think it's someone or something, but some things just can't be explained. And the ending scene is amazing, and I'm not going to talk about it because I really want you guys to go see it for yourself. The ending scene is magnificent. I really like it. I was like, oh man, really? But it's great. I mean, they come to a resolve, of course. But the ending scene is amazing. But yeah, they really just reduced to, what the fuck am I saying? They reduced, is what I was trying to say, to living like animals, like I said, or I guess the people below them of the lower class, as they would see or imagine, I'm assuming. Over the few days they're stuck in there, the facades they built up, by their virtue or position in society or whatever, they starts to collapse and fall, and they become just humans again. And that's when they really get to see and know each other and see each other for who they really are. And it's a very interesting look into people, into, like, the human condition. And I just think it's a great film. Like I said, it's a really good look into the human condition and people being people. When all this fails, when there's nothing left, what are you at the end of the day? You're still a person. And that's what this movie is pretty much talking about, even though it's listed as a comedy, which, like I said, I could see how it is a comedy. But yeah, you see, they get to know each other for who they truly are. They see each other for what they really are, people. And some good people, some bad people, some crazy people, some crazy and good. Excuse me, fuck shit down. Some crazy good people, some crazy bad. Like, it's just, they see through the multiple facades, some elaborate pretenses, all this stuff that they built up for themselves. And they see what they really are. Like, how well do Edmundo, do you know Salvador? Was that his name? Like, whatever the other dude's name. Like, it's like, how well do you guys know each other? And what actions would you take together when you're so-called really great friends when it comes down to survival and helping each other survive when you guys can clearly work together to survive? And they do work together in some teams to survive. They do help each other out. Like, they get water together and stuff like that. And they figure out how to get food later. That was also said earlier. I'm actually re-recording this part, so I don't remember if I talked about this part, this thing, but it's really weird. Some scenes happen twice, and it's full-on intentional, because, I mean, you could tell. Because the acting, like, the part, like, something would be slightly different, or, like, they would acknowledge it. Like, the guest arrives first. They give a speech first to Amanda. I'm really hoping that's the main character, or the guy that's more of the centerpiece of the film, because it doesn't really feel like there's a main character. But, yeah, it's like, what the fuck? It's like, I think pretty sure he's the one that gives a speech twice, and it's the exact same speech or toast.
Álvaro, parece que el mundo quiere decir algo.
Por la deliciosa noche que nos ha ofrecido nuestra amiga Silvia, con su estupenda creación de la novia virgen de la mermur. ¿Cómo estás? Lo de novia pase, pero lo de virgen.
Lo de virgen le hubiera ido mejor a la Valquiria.
¿La Valquiria?
Sí. A Leticia. Yo la nombro así porque es fiera y virgen.
¿Virgen? ¿Pero usted cree?
Dicen que todavía conserva ese objeto. Tal vez se trata de una perversión.
Por la deliciosa noche que nos ha ofrecido nuestra amiga Silvia, con su estupenda creación de la novia virgen de la mermuz.
But yeah, I say watch the movie and see what things that you can see. Oh wait, what the fuck am I saying? Why do I keep doing this video? I say watch this movie and point out things that you notice happen twice, because I know quite a few people have. Some people say it's not a lot, but I feel like it's more. I feel like I'm missing something. I'm not going to say they missed something, because they probably counted them all, and I just might be tripping. But me, myself, I feel like there's more things that happen twice, because the ones I remember vividly are the guests arriving twice and the two maids talking about it, or talking while it happens, like, wait, what the fuck? And when they're at the dinner table and a character gives a toast twice with the same exact speech, and he's like, wait, what the fuck? So yeah, I say really watch this movie, though. It's an amazing surrealist film. Like, I say it's amazing. It's very visually pleasing. I like there's not really a score. Well, it's a very subtle score. So I like that. And it's in black and white, which in my opinion kind of helps these styles of film. So I say go watch this crazy surrealist fantasy somehow comedy film, because this is amazing, and there's literally a million ways to interpret films, but this movie, this literally, well, people say that, but for this movie, I know for a fact it's literally a million ways to interpret this film. And I wanted to initially make an analyst or breakdown video, but I actually didn't want to do that because there's so many things that this movie can mean, and like, I for one, I actually don't know where to start. I think it's just a play on a classism, like it's talking about that in short. So, but besides that, it's like, I really don't know. Because they're just confined to this one room. That's pretty much it. Oh, there's some funny scenes, though, where you can see, like, their mics, their boom mics in the shot. It's pretty funny. Like, you can see it clearly on the table, and, like, no one says anything. But, yeah, this movie's amazing. It has amazing scenes. The scene where a character is playing the piano and singing, and they do that scene again later with more importance. I really like that. That was beautiful.
A mal tiempo, buena cara. Tenemos que vernos muy a menudo, ¿verdad? No faltaba más. Por lo pronto, ven mañana a casa y le regalaré una caja. Cuidado, no estamos solos. Te voy a presentar al señor Sergio Russell.
No se moleste. Sigan presentándose. Yo no estoy para jerigonzas. Con permiso.
Este Russell es un excéntrico.
Debe ser hombre de letras.
Allá es. Bueno, ahora, si les parece, vamos a oír a Blanca.
There's scenes between this couple, these two characters as a couple, that are amazing. They have a lot of good scenes in my opinion. They're two of my favorite characters, or two favorite aspects of the movie, excuse me.
¿Te han visto?
Sí. No sé. Da igual.
I actually like every character in this movie, even the more bitchy ones, and the ones I kind of hated, because they're really good actors, and they played the part, and they looked the part, so that was amazing. Set design was nice, costume design was nice, score was nice. Like, I really enjoyed this movie. It was really clever, really visually stunning, and I really think you guys should watch it. And like I said, I don't want this to sound like a review, but it sounds like a review. I hate giving movie scores, but I literally gave this movie an 8 out of 10. But yeah, that's the Exterminating Angel, in short, without spoiling anything. This is just a little topic and a blah 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 discussion video on it. I say most definitely watch it. Like I said, it's a short, well, it's not really short, it's not too long though. It's like a little over an hour and a half. Actually, might be an hour and a half without credits, maybe even shorter. But yeah, like I said, short little surrealist film. Why do I keep saying short little? But it's just a little, it's not little, it's just a film, a surrealist film made by Luis, I can't see his last name, Manuel. Starring all Mexican cast, it's pretty great. It's weird, it's amazing, it's freaky, I love it. It's very mysterious, even though it's not under mystery. I like it, and it's a pretty great movie, man. And it's twists and turns in it, and it's just amazing. And I say watch it. And I know I started doing anime videos, but this being my first film video after, what, two, three anime videos. I'm going to start back uploading more film videos. But I actually think my next video will be an anime video, but that is a film video. It's a it's an anime video about a film that just so happens to be anime. It's the Animatrix. I'm gonna start a series on that, on each part. So I think the movie has 10 parts, if I remember correctly. So I was gonna make a video discussing each part, so that might be a 10-part miniseries. I'm not sure if I wanna upload them all in a row or just break it up in between. And I always upload, my upload schedule is crazy because I really just get lazy and do whatever. So yeah, but I'll figure it out. And I actually want to make a video on The Matrix itself, and that how a copied off of Blade, well, it's straight up copied off of Blade, though I think Blade deserves more credit, because that's like The Matrix and other movies, like superhero movies, wouldn't be the same if Blade wasn't a thing. What else? I'm probably going to make a video on a joke video. I haven't done one of those in a while. It's going to be about how Super Mario Odyssey stole from a Bugs Bunny game, a 90s Bugs Bunny game on PlayStation 1. It didn't, just a lot of similarities that I find funny. Oh, what else? Yeah, just more film videos. I'm probably going to cover more obscure, small film videos since I have a huge list of movies that I've seen. I want to start a Midnight series and a Blaxploitation series. So be on the lookout for those. I'm going to cover movies like, I want that to be that surprise. So yeah, but basically expect The Animatrix. I went blank. The Animatrix, possibly The Matrix, Matrix / Blade. Smaller, obscure movies. Anime. Yeah, I'm still going to do anime. Blaxploitation, The Animatrix. What else? Horror. I really want to do more horror movies. And just smaller movies in general. So, yeah. Expect that from me and talk to you guys later.
Aquí, desemboca al mar.
No llego.
Desciende más. Ya, el ritus. Horrible.
Amor mío.
Muerte mía. Horrible. Oh,